You're with Michael for the Bad, Dangerous and History World Tours. Out of these, do you have a favourite world tour and why?
Wow. The answer is not just a straight answer. Bad because it was my first time entering that world. So the first time I ever experienced that. So wow, you know, so bad because of that. But also the other thing is I appreciated the progression of Michael's artistry, his songwriting and his more, by the time he got to history, his songwriting was more like a Stevie Wonder, like him talking about his life and stuff that was going on. So I liked the songs better as he went on, because he also went from, the first tour still had a lot of the Jackson stuff. Mm-hmm. As he went on, you know, I went on his first tour as Michael Jackson the artist. So I went on all the tours as Michael Jackson the artist. So as he became more of Michael Jackson the artist telling his own personal stories, those tours got better artistically and musically for me, right? So history, you know, then I loved, you know, the music of history. I remember thinking, I put the needle down on the beginning of history. I mean, usually I find one song. If I love a song on an album, I will play that song for 6 months before I play another song on the album. Mm-hmm. Well, this one, because I heard a couple of different ones on the radio, so I started playing them. I put the needle down. People don't even know what put the needle down means now, right? I would start one song and just let it play through. And I was like, wow, you know, that's something I would do on Stevie Wonder album or, you know, some other, like, wow, I'm doing that. Because Michael Jackson's albums would have hit records progressively by the time we got to history. Wow, it was like a story being told and complimentary, one song to the next, more organic. So that's the answer to that. Bad because it was the first time going there, but then the tours got progressively better musically and artistically for me.